Golden, and welcome to my vlog. Alright, so today we are doing another Fanfluence video. Hoping you've seen the last two and sort of know what I mean when I say that. If not, go check out the last two first and then come back to this one. This one's probably going to be the shortest of three, because this is going to try to keep within the new shorter format. With that said, let's just launch straight into it. So, the first thing I want to talk about today is Star Trek. Yes, I am a bit of a Trekkie. Probably not so much now as I was at various times when I was younger. But Star Trek is one of those things that's always, it's there. I enjoy it when I watch it. I enjoy, you know, various things about it. I haven't seen, like, everything to do with it. I'm not that much of a Trekkie. There are certainly series that I prefer and that I like watching. And series that I think are okay or haven't really seen very much of. You know, generally, I'm a fan of the bits that I'm a fan of, and I'm not a fan of what I'm not a fan of. The one thing that I do know is that it's one of those things that's sort of always been there. There is this story that I get told that my dad almost missed my birth because he was watching an episode of Star Trek. So I think I was kind of born to be a Trekkie, and that's kind of the way that I've always sort of looked at it. And I know it seems like a weird reason to think about, and a weird reason to sort of be into a TV series or a show or whatever. I think it's very much true. I don't think I would be a Star Trek fan if it wasn't for the fact that my parents both watched it, so it was on. Although saying that, neither of my brothers paid any attention to it. They didn't sort of adopt it in the same way that I did. But I very much think that, you know, if it wasn't for that, if it wasn't sort of there in the background sort of as I was growing up, I probably wouldn't like it as much as I do it, you know. I would definitely say that my favourite sort of series is probably The Next Gen. That's the one that I grew up with. That's one that, you know, used to come on to BBC Two just after we'd finished eating dinner, and I would always watch, so it's very much a nostalgia thing for me. And after that I'd probably say Voyager, and then maybe DS9, and then everything else. Which I know there are probably, you know, proper Trekkies out there who'd absolutely crucify me for looking at it that way, and I don't really like the original series, no particular reason. I've seen bits and pieces of it, I just don't connect as well with the characters, and I think that's sort of what it comes down to. I'm very much a person that if I can't connect with any of the characters, then it's very difficult for me to enjoy what I'm watching. I'm, you know, it's just the way I am, and certainly more so with my preferred Star Trek series is than anything else, and you know, yeah. So that's the first one covered. You can see we're going to be flying through this a little bit more. So the second thing I want to talk about is Red Dwarf. So in keeping with the sort of sci-fi theme, I guess. Again, Red Dwarf is one of those things that I have very distinct memories of from my childhood. Certainly, you know, one of my aunts and uncles was quite into it, and, you know, when we were over at theirs, we'd occasionally watch some of their VHS tapes, as it was back then. I'm that old. It's certainly something that, you know, I've seen most of the more recent series. I've not seen the latest one that came out, I think, earlier this year yet. I do plan to eventually sort of catch myself up on it, but I don't really watch TV as much anymore as I watch things online. So that can be very difficult then, keeping up with series that, you know, are sort of TV released. you do have to be very much more aware of sort of when things are sort of coming out and schedules and stuff, and I'm not always as up to it as I should be, so sometimes I'll sort of realise that a series is, you know, now airing and do a massive crash course and catch up on things and certain things. I think I sort of decided that I was going to wait until all the episodes were out anyway, before catching up on my Red Dwarf. Just because it's the episodes are only generally about half an hour long anyway, so it makes more sense doing it that way and doing it in one session and sort of enjoying it like that. As a child, it was very much all about Lister and the cat. They were definitely my favourite characters. As an adult, and this is something I found when I rewatched the series properly a few years ago, I'm very much more about Rumour. And I don't know where the change sort of came, but sort of when you sort of approach it more, you know, as an adult, he's a funnier character in a lot of ways. He certainly, you know, I don't know. So yeah, that's kind of how my view of the dwarf has changed. I don't know what that sort of says about childhood me and then the adult me, but I think, yeah. I think this is about all I can say about Red Dwarf, since I'm not as caught up on it as I should be. So that gives us plenty of time, in theory, to talk about the last thing on my list today. And we are sticking with TV shows this time. I know in previous ones I've sort of mixed it up a bit and thrown in a bit of curveball at the end or whatever. My Little Pony. Friendship is Magic, specifically. So, as I mentioned before, I have brothers. I'm the only girl, I'm also the middle child. This is important because growing up, I did not get to watch very many girly shows, or shows specifically aimed at girls. In fact, I'm not sure I watched any. There was sort of this unspoken rule in the house where we weren't allowed to watch anything unless there was a majority ruling on it. Which, you know, meant that I ended up watching a lot more of the cartoons aimed at boys than anything else, all the sort of gender neutral stuff. You know, it saved on arguments and, you know, saved on having, you know, too much going through the TV, because we only really had one TV for a lot of the time when I was growing up. We didn't have cable or Sky or anything like that. Not until we reached our teens, and at which point we all had very different separate TV viewing habits anyway, so there wasn't the clash so much then. But I do know My Little Pony was definitely something that was very much around when I was a kid, you know, and I have friends who have very fond memories of watching things like Sailor Moon and My Little Ponies and Care Bears. I have none of those memories because I didn't watch it. I was definitely aware of Care Bears and My Little Pony, to the point where I did have a couple My Little Ponies, which I'm pretty sure were hand-me-downs from some of my older cousins, rather than things that had been bought new for me, or else had been picked up secondhand somewhere. Because I don't really remember acquiring them, I just remember them sort of being there. Sailor Moon, on the other hand, I have no memories of as a child at all whatsoever, even though like most of my friends do, and it's like really weird. I'm kind of like, yeah, that wasn't a thing. I never watched that. So, needless to say, when I sort of was at university and I had some friends that were sort of recommending me mostly anime at the time. I do like my anime. And these same friends were sort of like, hey, you should watch the new series for My Little Pony, it's actually rather good. Needless to say, I was kind of skeptical, because growing up when you don't really watch girly shows, they're sort of not necessarily put you against it, but it is sort of, it's not something you particularly look for. If it's something you've never sort of had, it's not something you sort of particularly look for, things sort of aimed more at women. I do have a tendency more towards sort of gender neutral stuff, as it were. But anyway, this these particular friends had given me some pretty sound recommendations before, so I figured, you know, why not? Let's give it a go. And yeah, I kind of never looked back. I think sort of at the time was partly because I did have the people there who I could talk to about it, and shared experiences always sort of make things better. But as I've sort of gotten older and I've sort of lost touch with all of those people, I'm more sort of into it, sort of partly because I do enjoy it, and it, you know, you can't watch a show like that and not enjoy it. I'm not saying that I enjoy every single episode. There are definitely certain episodes where I'm kind of like, meh, why am I watching this? And other episodes where I'm like, oh yeah, that's exactly why I'm watching this. This show is amazing. And you know, a lot of bits which are sort of in between those two sort of reactions. I think what sort of keeps me going a little bit more now is a lot of the YouTube reviewers, the who I refer to as the pony reviewers, but I think they're the brony reviewers, technically speaking. There's something, I mean, it's sometimes I enjoy watching their reviews more than I've enjoyed watching the actual episode, but you need to have seen the episode to enjoy the reviews. So I do, yeah, I do sort of consider those two things being sort of rolled up into the same sort of thing. So I like My Little Pony Friendship is Magic, and I like the reviewers on YouTube who review My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. Those two things are sort of very, very much the same thing in my head. And yeah, that probably is a little bit weird, but I've said before that I am a fangirl who likes fan things, so it does kind of make sense that I would be a fan of something and then fans of that something. So take from it what you will. having said that, for My Little Pony, I'm not so much into the original stuff. I don't read the fanfics. I don't watch a lot of the very creative videos and things that people make for it. Though I am aware of a lot of it, and there are bits and pieces that I have seen. And yeah, there are a lot of talented people within the pony community, definitely. So it's one of those things where it's kind of like, I could be more into it if I wanted to be, but there are other shows and other things that I follow that I'd much more rather be part of those communities. And as far as I am a part of this community, it's good for me. I wouldn't necessarily want to be more into it than I am. But I am aware that there is this other amazing stuff that goes on, and it is really clever and it is really creative, and you know, there should be praise going out to those people from the right people. yeah. Oh, we'll go with that. anyway, I think that's quite a good length for this one. Doing well with this, aren't I? So, on the next one, I know the last few couple of influences I've sort of gone into sort of technical writey bits and pieces, but I think what I'm going to do on the next one is I'm finally going to talk about those poetry videos that are on my channel, because they are there, and I'm not taking them down, I'm not ashamed of them, and I'm not trying to necessarily bring more attention to them, but a lot of them do have a lot more views than my vlog videos, so I certainly need to address them, as it were. Alright, so that's what we're going to be doing next time, and until next time, see ya!